Hello everyone, welcome to the course of computer networks specifically for the gate purpose. In this lecture we will discuss about the Backoff algorithm. We will discuss this algorithm in context of the CSMA/CD actually. Okay, let's see what we will cover in this lecture. We will see what is the problem with CSMA/CD, and then we will introduce the Backoff algorithm. Actually we use the Backoff algorithm to resolve the problem occurring in CSMA/CD. So first I will share the problem with you related to CSMA/CD, then to solve this problem actually we will use this algorithm, Backoff algorithm. Then we will see the working of Backoff algorithm and then some advantages and disadvantage of Backoff algorithm. Let's start with the problem with CSMA/CD. Okay, let's see the problem with CSMA/CD. Let me read the statement. Two stations may get stuck into multiple collisions. Two stations may get stuck in multiple collisions due to transmission of data frame every time at the same point of the time. What this statement says is, okay, let me show you with this diagram. This is the channel and this is station 1. And this is station 2. Okay, we have two stations and this is the channel. Okay, this is the timeline. This is the timeline time. Okay, and this is channel. Okay, they sense the channel and they find that okay, channel is free and they transmit the signal. This one also, and they get stuck into a collision. Then they wait for some time, both of them, and again retransmit the signal. This one also. They again get stuck into the collision. They again, S1 again wait for some time, and S2 also wait for some time, and they again transmit the signal. They get stuck into the collision again. Actually, they may get stuck into the collision for many times, for multiple collisions may occur in this way. Actually this can happen actually in the case of CSMA/CD. What is happening is collision is occurring, both are waiting for approximately or same amount of time, and both are start transmitting the data at the same time. Again collision will occur definitely because they are transmitting data at the same time. Again, after waiting for some time, they again transmit the data at the same time. Again collision will occur. Again there may be collision. There may be any number of collisions actually in this case. So that is the problem with CSMA/CD. So to resolve this problem actually we use the Backoff algorithm. Okay, introduction to Backoff algorithm. Backoff algorithm is a collision resolution mechanism used in CSMA. So the collision was occurring, we have seen. To resolve that collision we use the Backoff algorithm. To resolve that particular problem we use the Backoff algorithm. Actually how Backoff algorithm works is given in the second statement. For how much amount of time a station should wait after collision, that is decided by the Backoff algorithm. Backoff algorithm actually decide once the collision occur. This is the stations and let's suppose this transmitted, this one person also transmit, collision occur, and then for how much time, let's suppose S1 is waiting for this much amount of time to make the second transmission, but S2 may be waiting more amount of time. So S2 is transmitting at this time. So at this time, there will be no collision with this signal. Okay, so how much amount of time S2 and S1 should wait, that is decided by the Backoff algorithm. So that how much amount of time S2 have to wait, S1 have to wait, so that collision do not occur. So this time is decided by this time, so that they do not transmit at the same time. So this time is decided by the Backoff algorithm. Okay, but in back of algorithm actually only two stations works. So back of algorithm works only for two stations if there are two stations over the channel. Okay, in that case back of algorithm work only for two stations. Okay, so this was the introduction to back of algorithm, but how actually back of algorithm work, what is the principle behind which back of algorithm work. Let's see the actual working of the back of algorithm now in detail. Let's start with the first step. First step is saying that two stations A and B start transmission at the same time. Okay, let me draw it. This is the channel, this is station A, and this is station B. They start transmission at the same time, and definitely there will be collision if they are starting at the same time. And after collision, second point, a collision number n will be assigned to the to each frame involved in the collision. So actually A is sending a frame, this frame. Okay, let's suppose this frame is this is first frame actually, and B is also sending its first frame F1. Okay, both are sending the frame. We need to assign a collision number to each of the frame involved in the collision. Okay, these are the two frames involved in the collision. Let me differentiate them. This is F1, this is F1. Let me write it as a AF1. This is frame AF1, means first frame, frame 1 sent by A station. This is frame 1 sent by B station. Okay, let me give this name to it, this name to this frame. Okay, this frame was sent over it, but and this frame was sent over here, but they crashes here, both of them. Okay, collision occur here. Okay, now we need to assign a collision number n. So so for this frame AF1, this frame, the collision number for this frame is 1, means this is the first collision occur for this frame. Actually this frame, first time this frame was sent by A, and that gets stuck into the collision. The similar way here also the collision number will be 1. Why collision number 1 will be 1 here? Because this frame, this particular frame, gets stuck into the collision first time. This may get stuck into collision second time also, the same frame I'm sending second time, that may get stuck into another collision. So then the collision number will be 2 here, then the n will be 2. Again I'm sending the same frame, maybe get again that gets stuck into the collision, then the collision number will be 3. So right now the collision number for this frame is 1 and this frame is also 1. Okay, and okay, so second point is done. Let's see the third point. The collision stations wait for some time based upon integer value between this to this, 0 to 2 power n minus 1. What third point is says that, so the collision is occur, after collision now A will wait for some time, similarly B will also wait for some time. Okay, so how much time A and B will wait, that will depend upon this range actually, according to back of algorithm. What this range is, let me find out the range for A station. Let me find out. So we know the range lie between 0 to 2 power n minus 1. Similarly here also, 0 to range lie from 0 to 2 minus n minus 1. What this range is? This range will help us to decide, okay, after how much time A can send this frame again, and after how much time B can send this frame again, how much time. Okay, so the value of this range will be 0, and what will be n value is 1, so 2 power 1 minus 1 is 1. This actually, this set is represented with k. Okay, here also the set is represented with k. In this set there will be two values, 0 because n is 1 here, so this 2 power 1 is 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay, so actually this set is represented with k at both sides. This set is actually known as, this set is known as contention window or contention set. Okay, and actually this set will help us to decide to decide about how after how much time A will send the frame, this frame again, and after how much time B will send the this frame which gets stuck into collision again. Okay, based upon this set. How based upon this set? Let me show you. We need to make a table for that with the combinations of these two sets, actually the set for A and the contention set for B. If we make the combination of both of them, we get four combinations: 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1. What these combinations are actually, according to first combination, I'm talking about this first combination. This is first, this is second, this is third, this is fourth. I'm talking about first combination. First combination is saying that, okay, A will transmit after zero amount of time, and B will also transmit after zero amount of time. Actually, that is calculated like this. A for A value zero, actually A will transmit. Let me write here. A will transmit after how much time? 0 into t slot time. Actually, after t slot time, A will transmit. What it means is 0 into t slot time. T slot time is actually a random amount of time. Decided by the algorithm, and 0 is deciding the unit. Okay. So based upon this set, station will transmit the data after some random amount of time. Okay. For what it means is, I'm repeating this thing now. For this combination, first combination, A will transmit actually immediately. Why immediately? Because 0 into this time slot will be 0. So A will transmit immediately. For this set, first set. B will also actually transmit immediately. Why? Because 0 into t slot will be 0 itself. So B will also transmit immediately. Actually, for first case, they will get again stuck into the collision. You can see, because both are transmitting immediately, because the value here is 0. The value here is 0. So both will transmit immediately. What about case 2? This was the case 1. Let me show the case 2. In case 2, A will transmit after this much amount of time, and B will transmit after 1 into T slot time. So you can see here is that A will transmit immediately. Why? Because 0 into time slot will be 0. Whatever this time is set by the algorithm, that will go 0. Means in the second case, A will transmit immediately, but B will wait, because 1 is here. So B will wait for this amount of time. B will wait for some more amount of time. That will not immediately transmit. That will wait for some time. For how much time? For T slot time. Okay, so you can see here that in this case, in second condition, collision will not occur here. Collision will not occur in the second case. What about third case? See the third case. Let me show you the third case. In third case, A will transmit after, see, 1 is here, into after this much amount of time. Okay, and B will transmit after 0 into time slot, T side time slot. So we can say that, okay, in third case, B will immediately transmit the data. But A will wait for some time. Okay. What about the fourth case? Let me write the fourth case. For fourth case, A will transmit after this much amount of time. T slot time is actually decided by the algorithm. That is just a fixed random time. And for B also, this value is 1, that will be 1 into T slot. This is actually how back of algorithm is working. That's it. I'm showing the working of back of algorithm. I'm not showing it from my side, anything. Okay. So in you can see that A is transmitting after this much amount of time, after one time slot, and B is also transmitting after one time slot. Actually, that is waiting for, let's suppose, one time slot. This is T slot, one up to here, let's suppose, up to here, and here also this is T slot. So actually both are again transmitting at the same time. In fourth case also both are transmitting, because this is same as this one. So both are waiting for same amount of time and both are again transmitting at the same time. Okay, so here also collision will occur. Let me summarize all the parts of this table. Actually, in the first case, in the first part, first combination, for the first combination, collision will occur. We can say collision will occur. Why? Because both will transmit at the same time. Both, nobody will wait. Okay, so here collision will occur. Let me write C here, C for collision. Okay, and what about this case? In this case, collision will not occur. Why collision will not occur? Because A will transmit immediately, but B will not transmit immediately. B will wait for T slot time. So collision will not occur here. But who will win? Who will win? A win or B win? A win means A will transmit earlier than B. In this case, A will transmit immediately, but B will wait. So I will say that, okay, A will win here. Let me rub the board. Let me rub the board and write all these things. Okay, let me lick the pen again. So in this case collision is occurring. In this case collision is not occurring, and who is winning? Who winning means who is transmitting earlier? A is transmitting immediately. So A will transmit earlier, then B will transmit. So I can say that A will win. Okay, in this case. What about in this case? In third case, A will wait for some time, T slot time, but B will transmit immediately. Okay, I can say that, okay, in this case, B will win. Okay, what about this case? In this case, both will wait for some time, for same amount of time, for T slot of time, and both will then transmit the data. Then again, collision will occur. So this is the case of collision. So you can say that in four cases, two cases belong to collision. Okay, so I can say that they are 2/4. There are four cases, two are of collision. So 50% chance of collisions are there. And if I am using the back of algorithm right now in this situation, actually this whole situation is actually the case one of back of algorithm. This is case one of back of algorithm. Okay, still back of algorithm is not stopped yet. Okay, this is actually how back of algorithm will behave when first time collision will occur. Okay, and after that, how that will take the decision. Okay, so who will transmit? A will transmit or B will transmit it. If this number is get selected, then A will transmit. If this number is get selected, then B will transmit. Okay, what is the probability of selecting this number? That is 1/4. What is the probability of selecting this combination? Again, that is 1/4. 25%. 25% chances are there that A will transmit earlier. 25% chances are that B will transmit earlier. Okay, and 50% chances is that again collision will occur. Again, they will send the same frame, both of them, and collision will occur. 50% chances are for collision for this case, first case, and fourth case. Okay. Okay, and this complete stage is known as the case one of the back of algorithm. Let's move to the case two of the back of algorithm. Case two is just follow of the case one. Means we are assuming that case one has occurred already. Means in case one, actually already collision have occurred. Okay, now we are moving to the case two. So this is the working of case 2. I will explain all of this step now. Okay, let's start with the first line. Assume A wins the case 1. Now A wins the case one, okay, then and transmitted its data frame. Let me show you this thing. Okay, let me show you. So here is the channel, and here is A station, here is B station. Okay, now we are assuming that in case one, first time when this was transmitting the frame, this was also transmitting the frame, okay, A wins. If A wins means A successfully transmitted the frame. We are assuming that A wins means A successfully transmitted the frame. Now what is the situation here? Now A have already transmitted the frame. Now this is F2 actually, this is second frame, this is second frame A want to transmit now, and this is still first frame, this is first frame. Okay, let me write, give another name to this. We can write this as this frame as BF1, means first frame of B station. This can be written as AF2, second frame of A station. I am repeating the same thing again. In second case is the extension of the first case. We are assuming that first case has already occurred, and in the first case we are assuming that A win the first case. If A win the first case, A already transmitted its first frame, but B still need to transmit its first frame, okay, because A wins, so A transmitted the first frame, but B still do not transmit its first frame. Okay, then what will happen here is, see, if A have transmitted the first frame, now let's suppose now A transmit the frame, the same time now B also transmit the frame, and collision occur. Now what is the collision number? Collision number n for A. So collision number for this frame will be 1. What do you mean by this is, this frame is get stuck into collision first time. This frame, F2 frame, get stuck into collision first time. And what is the collision number of this frame, F1? Collision number of F1 will be 2. What it means is that this frame gets stuck into collision second time. In first time, this frame was stuck into the case 1. Okay, now second time it gets stuck into case 2. So this part is important. So collision number for this frame is 2, means second time this frame is get stuck into collision, but this is the first time this frame gets stuck into collision. This is the first time, for because this is the second frame, this is the second frame of A station. Okay, let me read all these statements. So first we have done, assume A win the case 1, because A win the case 1, so A will send the second frame and transmitted its data frame. Okay, now assume as soon as B transmitted frame 1, B transmit its frame 1, A will transmit frame 2, hence collision will occur. So we are assuming that, okay, B is transmitting frame 1, and A is transmitting frame 2, A is transmitting frame 2. As both are transmitting at the same time, collision will occur. Okay, we have already assumed these two things, we have already done. Now we have already actually calculated n value also. See, now collision number n become 1 for frame 2. Frame 2 of A station, and n will become 2 for frame 1, and will become 2 for frame 1 of station B. Yes, we have already done this step also. Okay, let's move on. Now for frame 2 of station A, contention set, let's write the contention set. We know that what is the range of contention set, that is 0 to 2 power n minus 1. Here also 0 to 2 power n minus 1. So the range for contention set here will be 0, n value is 1, so 2 power 1 is 2, minus 1 is 1. This is the contention set for A, for frame 2, this part is important, we are talking about second frame here. So the contention window for frame 1 of B station is 0, comma, what is the value of n? 2. So 2 power 2 is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3, so 0 to 3. So this is the contention window of F1 frame of B station. This is the contention window of F2 frame of A station. Let me now make that table for them. So how many combinations will be there between A and B? If we make the combinations of both of the contention windows, so for 1 0 there will be 4 values, for this one there again will be 4 value. Let me write 0 0 0 0. For this 0 there will be 4 different combinations, 1 0 1 2 3, and for this one also 4 combinations, 1 1 1 1, so 0 1 2 3. So these are the different combinations possible between the contention windows of both the stations. Okay, let's see now, based upon this table, let's see how many collisions will occur now. Now collisions have already occurred. Now they want to send the frame, they want to get the time, at which time now A will retransmit the F2, at which time now B will retransmit F1. They are finding out that time, okay. That time is find out with the help of this combination actually, okay. Out of these combinations, one combination will be selected. Let's see how many combinations will lead to the collision and how many combinations will make successful to the A station to send frame 2. And how many combinations here out of these 8 combinations will make B successful to send F1 frame. Let's see this data. Okay, for A value 0 and B value 0, we know that for A 0, A will not wait, A will send the data immediately and B will also send the data immediately. Because this is how we calculate how much time A will wait, how much time B will wait. This 0 0 I pick from here, and this is the constant time that is decided by the algorithm. So both will send the data immediately, so collision will occur. What about in this case? In this case, A will send immediately but B will wait, so I can say A wins here. Win means A will send earlier than B. In this case, A will send immediately and B will wait for two time slots. So A will again win here. In this case, A will send immediately, B will wait for 3 time slots. Okay, so A wins here. A will send earlier than B. In this case, B win. In this case, both will wait for 1 time slot. So after 1 time slot, they will send the data at the same time actually. So collision will occur. What about in this case? A will wait for 1 time slot, B will wait for 2 time slot. So A will win, A will send the data first. So here also A will send the data first. So here, from here I can say that how many collisions are occurring? 2 out of 8 means 1 by 4. So 25% still chances that collision may occur, okay. But you can see that 5 out of 8 time A have more chance to send the data as compared to B. See, B can send only 1 time, 1 out of 8. So from this here I can say one thing: A have more chance to send the data as compared to B in this second case, okay. Second point I can say that earlier The chances of collisions were, in the case 1, the chances of collisions were 50%, but in case 2, the chances of collision is reducing. And when we will move to the case 3, case 4, case 5 and so on, the collision number of chance of collision will reduce further actually. Okay, but the problem here is that because A wins in the first case. So in the second case also, A get more chance to win. Why A get more chance to win? Because A actually wins in the first case. So due to that, its contention window will be bigger. Its contention window will be smaller, and which makes the possibility of winning A more as compared to B. Okay, so simple I can say that whoever will win the first case, that will get more chance to win into the second case actually. So that is actually drawback of the back of algorithm. Okay, so this is the second case and this will keep moving on. And in third case there will be more bigger window. If we can move to the third case. So this is actually how back of algorithm works. Let's see now the drawbacks of the back of algorithm. First, let's see advantage. Advantage is collision probability decrease exponentially. Every time collision probability is decreasing. In the first case that was 50%, in the second case that was 25%, in the third case that will again reduce. Okay, so this is the advantage of using the back of algorithm. What is the disadvantage? Disadvantage is the capture effect. What is the capture effect? Station who wins once keep on winning. The station who wins first time get more chance to win the second time, and get even better chance to win third time also. So this may lead to the starvations to the other stations to send the frame. Okay, so who win first time, that will get better chance to win in the second case and further on. So that is known as capture effect. So who win first time, that will capture the channel actually. Okay, what is the disadvantage? Second disadvantage, only two stations actually host can be there on the channel if you want to use the back of algorithm. Okay, let's move on. Okay, that's it about this lecture. Thank you.